Man, you see, it's not the white man, the access of evil. Evil becomes a part of man.
The access of evil.
No, because the other man
who destroyed
him.
The ozone layer. When the engine, when the steam engine
is at the period, the ozone layer is still here. It ain't completely destroyed.
Brother,
that's not. Now you got me.
When the black man
the created the Arab engine, is just on, brother, as devastating
brother,
to me as this. But see, we talk,
hold on. We're talking about who our people know, which is the white man.
And they
our
know the
people,
Arab.
Hold on, brother.
No, they know
hold
the
on,
Arab,
brother.
Too.
Hold on, brother.
That do they or do they
on,
not
brother.
Know the Arab?
Hold on, brother.
Do they or do
hold
they
on,
not
brother.
Know the
Arab? Brother.
You don't want to.
We're talking about the white man.
Listen. You're not going to be.
Brother. Listen,
you need to get a better teacher.
If you feel that way, go down the block.
You're not going to be.
If you feel that way, go down the block.
Because you're not.
From home.
I'm a black man without a place to call my own.
No place to call my own.
For Africa has forgotten me.
Forgotten.
And America just
ain't for me.
I am a million miles from home.
Hey, go see. Look how long now me get up and get fed up. Not shut about this pain. This pain be a stain. Cut to the soul, abandoned from birth. What is worth this American dirt? The earth fear domain. Plain and simple, making true by enemy. Back to the genes, the seeds that we see. The carbon is so populated from long ago. Amen, yeah. Ancient, I keep a line, spit me out. Africa pick me out and ship me out. Not slave trade condition, we my ambition be. Yearning back to the black womb. America will not be my tomb. Room to try to. Half a be barefoot, half a reach. One way or the other, by any means, Africa gleams. Longing to embrace me, they wait and get still. Hey, yo!
I am a million miles from home. Million
now, when you deal with the Greeks, the original Greeks were black.
That's a fact.
That was the minority. When you go, give me the sign. You got the sign or the sign is messed up? You got the sign?
The Greeks are the ones talking about here. The white Greeks originally come from Bulgaria.
No, I said, no,
they migrated down.
Check
the original Greeks were black.
Brother, yes,
that was the original
yes,
black Greeks.
Exactly.
That was the Minoan.
Now, understand.
The first civilization.
Let's get this Lord ahead. Now, when you understand that, those were the same. Now, that's the people during the Hellenistic period. Those were, listen, brother, those were the Greek-speaking Jews.
That's right.
And they were the ones that translated the Hebrew tongue into the Greek language. Because they were Greek, you understand? They were, understand
this. Hold on.
Damn, you're a
hold this. Now, watch this. Brother, wait a minute. Hold on, brother. Hold on. I'm going to show you something so you won't think. What up? Now, what you see is right here. All right? The Etruscans. This is the actual bus. In what? 400, 300 BC. Now, this is before the scriptures. Let me understand this, right? In Malta, here's a Greek man in Anatolia. In 200 BC. So when you see these people right here, hold on. Sorry, he need coffee. Alright, understand this. When you see these people right here, right? These were the people that translated. You see this?
We're just listening.
You see this?
Now watch this. Now watch it. Now watch it.
Hold on, wait, I ain't finished. Brother, I ain't finished.
Watch this.
Get the record. You from France?
Yeah. We're just listening.
Hey,
you said you're Muslims?
Where you at?
You're from France.
Yeah.
Where's your family origin from?
Algeria, in Africa.
Algeria,
yeah.
North Africa.
Yeah.
But is your, now we also must remember the Europeans who came up there.
See this right here?
The first one.
These are Greeks. You understand? Look at it. These are the original Greeks right here. Right? And now the talk, see that? So these are original Greeks. Here's the original Etruscans. So now when people speak about the translating of the language, right? These people here, they spoke Hebrew and Greek, and they translated what is known as the Septuagint. Okay? And now it wasn't. Now the word Septuagint means 70, but it was 72 scholars. Okay, that was summoned to go ahead and translate these scriptures. So when you understand this, this is who did it. Now when these people went and translated the scriptures, and you see that word. The word that he's speaking about, para, right? Okay, so meaning Pharaoh, that was a language that they had spoke. It was just a title. There was no existence at that time of someone called Pharaoh. Now, when you look at Joseph, Joseph was a visor. You understand? Unto Pharaoh, when you see this, okay? And a lot of people, they get it twisted. Joseph, so when you see that language, when he starts speaking and he says, para, this was going back and forth between Joseph, okay, who told the dream unto the man under the title Pharaoh at the time. So when you see this, all these translations that he speak about, all of these are people who taking that Hebrew.
So para is Greek. So para, watch this. So para is Greek.
Wrong.
Why are they not using it?
Brother, listen to me.
Why are not they using the title of the king of Egypt?
Listen to me, please.
So I have listened to you. I have listened to you.
The word Pharaoh is Greek.
Para. Pharaoh. The word para is Greek. And then it comes, it converts to para.
What does it mean?
Right?
What does it mean?
Para means great house.
And what does it mean?
Great house. It means great house. Great house. So now, watch this. So then the world is being misguided by the Greeks who are calling the king of Egypt, because that's all the knowledge that they have. Now the Septuagint comes around, and the Septuagint is doing something that you're not gonna, you know what the Septuagint did then? The Septuagint wrote the Torah.
You know, okay.
They wrote the Torah.
Stop.
They wrote the Torah.
Understand this.
Yes.
Let's work slowly and get an understanding. That's why you have to speak the language when you speak against, you know what I'm saying, the thing that you're talking about. First of all, the people of the Septuagint could not write the Torah simply because of this. What does the word Torah mean? First of all,
the law.
No, it doesn't, brother. The word Torah means instruction,
which is the law.
No. The word law comes from where? Do you know?
Moses.
No, it doesn't.
You know when they?
There's a tribe.
Okay, you can.
Listen, I'm gonna show you something. Please, I'm gonna show you something. Because there was a tribe that instructed the people in what to do. The Septuagint.
Instruction and law, or how far apart? How far apart? So you're playing a little semantics.
Not at all.
I said, if I would have said instructions, you would have said the law.
Okay, here's I'm gonna show you something. Listen to me, brother. I'm telling you through the language. Now hear me out. A teacher, what they do is teach. Is that correct?
That's correct.
But they teach particular subjects, right?
That's correct.
But their title still is teacher, correct?
That's correct.
The children of Levi in Hebrew are called lawyer. Look, the children of Levi, they went and taught the people the instructions of the Heavenly Father, which was the Torah.
Which
so
was the
now, brother, when you learn a language, you get it right.
No, we are just so now, saying, we're just speaking English. We're speaking Hebrew right now.
Check this out, and I'm going to tell you in English that you're a goddamn fool and an asshole because you're not paying attention to logic and reason.
Because
you ain't playing common sense and logic and reason.
You can't do that.
I'm
going to
show you why, King. Here's why.
You can't do that.
Because we're dealing with language.
Right, because, but then if that makes you a fool and a liar too.
All right,
because you in your holy book you got a word, a Greek word for king.
Because we spoke Greek. You don't get it. You don't get it.
No, I get it.
We spoke Greek.
Why is it in your holy book?
Hebrew?
Why isn't it?
You understand?
No,
we spoke.
It does not resolve to a Hebrew word. You know you have a problem.
Ignorance of our people. Our people again, we were told that the Greeks, the original Greeks were black, right? So now if the original Greeks are black, now when you look at the Hebrew Israelites, remember, they went into a particular captivity when the Greeks had went to rule. So now they were the Hellenistic Jews. They were Greek-speaking Jews. The Greek-speaking Jews translated the Hebrew language into the Greek. You have to understand that. It's real simple. It's not complicated.
No, they put together the whole book. They put together the whole book.
In terms of there's something called the lingua franca.
That's correct.
And it's called the Koine Greek. And the reason why they spoke Koine Greek was based upon training. It's just like we speak English today. It's based upon a particular instance. And that's why they were speaking Koine Greek.
Why is the lingua franca in your holy book?
Brother, half of the world at that time was speaking Koine Greek. And that's why you see that. Come on.
Why is it in your holy book? Why is it in your holy book? Why is a Greek word in your holy book?
That's the reason why you speak English.
Because if you were there in ancient Egypt at the time, you would know the name of the North Soot. You would know his name. There are no names that of any proper North Soot until Taharqa. Until Taharqa. But I don't want to take up all your time because y'all seem to know it all.
Don't worry about it.
You're
not.
Y'all seem to know it all.
Listen. If you just get this one thing, what we're trying to convey is this language, right? When we come out here, a lot of people think that we coming off the basis of, Hebrew is up all up, and reading the English to you. You got to understand this one thing. We speak the ancient Hebrew. We speak the Aramaic. We speak the Arabic. You understand? And we speak the Syriac languages and write these languages. So when we talk to the people, we can tell you these translations real easy. So now when somebody comes to us based off the English that you speak, we have the question, actually, you speak that language of antiquity in which it was translated from. You understand what I'm saying? It's that's not complicated. So when that way, it gives you a better understanding of that which you read.
It's simple. What you're saying, it's to authenticate your point of view.
Exactly. It's real simple. Real simple. Like a lot of brothers that speak about Egypt, so on and so, they can't even, they can't even read one line of the Metuneta. They can't even read one line of the Metuneta, but yet they talk about Egypt. Now that's what I'm trying to say. You understand what I'm saying? Now when they can read the Metuneta, then you have a better balance in what you speak about in Egypt. You understand? Just, you get what I'm saying, King? Alright, King. Alright. Be good, man. Alright? Yeah, don't sign that paper. Oh, don't sign that paper. Yo, hey! We want to hold you up to your promise, man. Alright.
Now, are you now, watch this. You understand what I'm saying, King? I understand with that. Now, here's the next thing. Are you all converts to Hebrew?
Not at all.
You were born Hebrew, or you came into some understanding
that you were. Very simple, brother. It's very, 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 very simple. When you go into the scriptures, right? How did our people come over here and just show us in North America? Some of our people.
Through slave trade, simple as that.
Slave ships, correct?
That's correct.
Now, let's see if that's found in the scriptures. Is that okay?
No, because that's not, it can't be found in the scripture, unless it's prophecy. Unless it's prophecy. Now, if it's prophecy, that's prophecy. And I respect that that's prophecy. But
so let me go there. So let me go there. All right, is that cool? Let's go there real quick. Just so you can see, right? So when a lot of brothers say, oh, white man, we can validate this, that these are black facts in this book. There's nothing in here that says the white man is great. But in here, it tells you that the black man is great. It tells you that you're above all people. There's nothing in here that say the white man is superior. But in here, it tells you that you're superior.
It's not true.
So how is it that somebody say, oh, the white man book, when it speaks black things? It don't make no goddamn sense. That's how you know these brothers don't read it. They tell, oh, you know, all they do is speak against it because they don't understand it. Because a lot of times inside of their heart, they say, yo, how the hell could them niggas dress like that, curse the white man out, be in a goddamn corner, tell him where to go, and nothing happened to him? You know why? Because we dealing with the oracles of the Most High. And the white man knows that, you know what, when he looks at this book, he says, goddamn, those are the people of that book.
Well, in actuality, that book is really a story about black men.
Exactly. But most people that deal with Africa don't even realize that. They talk about Kemet, and guess what? They can't find you one prophecy in the walls or on any papyrus that tells you that they were going to be in here in the shores of North America. Can't find it. But you can go in here and find prophecies that tells you this. But then they want to argue, how is that a prophecy? How is that a prophecy? Then all you got to do is ask them this. Well, show us where that fits the white man. Let's get the slave ships. Let's see this. Let's see if this fits the white man or don't fit our people. Read that, Lord.
Deuteronomy chapter 28,
come on.
Verse 68.
Come on.
And the Lord shall bring thee,
come on,
into Egypt again.
And the word Egypt, we know that it's a Greek word, right?
And you say it's Mesram.
I'm asking,
and there's Mesram.
You get Mesram.
If Egypt, you don't use Egypt in there. You use Mesram.
It's Greek. Oh, you check this out, brother. I'll just, don't.
I'm just making sure you're not going to trap me.
Not at all.
Because
I'm asking you, what does the word Greek in English mean? I mean, the word Greek itself mean. What does it mean? I mean, Egypt.
That was given by Ptolemy.
That's in the Ptolemy.
Egyptos.
Yeah, but that's simple.
We're going to show you what it means. Yes. It means bondage.
Okay? No, I don't agree with that.
No, what? No, listen.
No, I don't agree with
listen.
That. You can't do that with that.
I'm telling you.
I heard what you said.
You speak the
now, read your.
Do you speak the Greek? Do you speak the Greek?
We can look it up.
Do you speak it?
We can look it up.
Okay?
We can look it up.
You can look it up. And guess what the white man going to tell you? Oh, the land of Northern.
That's right.
That's what I'm going to tell you.
Okay.
But he's going to tell you, but they didn't
even. But no, we're not going to be able to prove that point right now. So let's keep it moving.
Into Egypt again with ships.
With what?
With ships.
With ships. The first time they was in Egypt. Now remember, they're supposed to have walked across the sea, right? Red Sea, right? Now you try to walk to New Jersey from here. You can't do it. So they went across the Red Sea, which is right there. So when you understand this, brother, watch this. In cargo slave ships, where did the white man go on cargo slave ships in history? That calls himself a Jew. When? Did it ever happen?
A white man, the Greeks enslaved other white men.
But did they ever go on cargo slave ships?
No. They were slave ships. They rolled them for war. They captured people and they were on ships. And then all those ships.
Brother.
No. All the Greek ships were slave ships.
Stop, brother.
The Roman ships were slave ships.
Brother, please.
I understand.
Let's get an understanding. When it speaks about the cargo slave ships.
We don't know. That's prophecy. We don't know exactly what they're talking about. You know that.
That's fine.
That's prophecy.
We speak Hebrew. We don't give a shit with no two-bit fake-ass Egyptologists, no. Because you don't understand the Hebrew, brother. You can't even speak the Metuneta. Tell me about the Metunet. Tell me about it, brother.
It means a divine word.
But you tell me. You give me a. You word. Give me a sentence on Metunet.
Hotep Dinar Sut.
Okay. Right. Now you. That's right. Something that you learned about Hotep Dinar Sut, right?
That's great.
Okay. Now you right. Tell me about Egypt. Tell me that.
What about Egypt?
Yeah. Tell me that.
That's a Greek word.
And tell me about Egypt. Tell me what's Egypt.
I can tell you the Nile Valley name.
You can't tell me the.
I can tell you the Nile Valley name of him.
Egypt is.
Tell me what Egypt is. Which was. Tineta, right?
Okay.
Right on Tineta.
Okay, brother.
I can tell you what the Metunet
is. Here's where you're wrong, brother. Understand
this
one thing.
No, I'm not wrong.
The Egyptians themselves, what did they call them at that time? What did they call themselves?
What did the people of Kemet call themselves?
What did they call themselves? Yes.
Between them, they called themselves the Remesh as the citizens.
Okay.
Right? Or the Kemetu, meaning the people of Kemet. That's what they called themselves.
Did they also call themselves the people of Tamere?
That's correct.
Okay,
Tamere, no. They called themselves Tamere
right.
Was the land.
Exactly.
All lands was Tamere, okay. Tanahisi, Ta.
Now, so when they dealt with that,
but they didn't call
that was the
Tamere.
First title that people that came into their land called them, the Tamereans.
No, when they didn't. They that's, now well, now we're talking
land.
English
they
now.
They spoke about land mass.
They say, no, they say, okay. They said the people of Kemet told them who
I got
they were.
You, brother.
The
I
people
got
of Kemet told
now,
them who
listen,
they were.
Listen, now in order for somebody to tell you who they are, that means you have to encounter them, correct?
That's correct.
Now before they encountered them, they called them by the landmass. Over here, they call people what? Americans. Because the landmass, America. So people that wasn't in that land, they called them the people of Tamere. You understand? Until they met them and then they told them who they were. Brother, you gotta get it right, brother. Come on,
you know
man.
Why you got it wrong?
Get it right.
Because you let's can't find
reading.
Me the let's word Tamere anywhere. Show me that, because it's not
the way
your
world.
Fault.
Watch this.
It's not your
by the way world.
Watch this, kid.
I speak unto thee.
Come on.
Thou shalt see it. No more again.
Come on, read.
And there,
come on.
Ye shall be sold.
You shall be what?
Sold.
You shall be what?
Sold.
Unto
whom? Unto your enemies.
Understand that. For what?
For bond men and bond women.
That's in the scriptures. Find that anywhere else.
Because that's what was happening in the ancient world.
You understand that?
Slavery was a part of the whole ancient world.
See, hold on, brother.
Slavery was part of the whole ancient world.
Here's what you
so you just can.
Okay, brother.
Here's what Brother Smiller realized about slavery. I understand what you're saying.
You understand what I'm saying? Okay.
There was captive. There's a difference between a certain captivity of war, and there's a difference between people being sold. Okay? It's a total difference. When you understand that the tribal, listen, Africa makes up what? It's a continent that has over 50 countries, correct? They had tribal wars. So they would go ahead and make captives of the people they conquered. But they never went and sold the next captive into the hands of someone else. So when you deal with this prophecy and speaking about someone that was a captive and they were sold unto their enemies, man.
But in the Moses law,
now we don't watch this.
Now in the Moses law,
come on, read on.
You, the Hebrews themselves are dealing with
someone said, for bond men. Come on, read.
For bond men.
Come on.
And bond women.
For slave men and slave women. Come on, read.
And no man shall buy you.
So no man was going to get us out that captivity through transaction and say, I want to buy my brother out of captivity. So when you see this, this only fits the so-called black man here in the shores of North America. This is us. We are the Hebrew Israelites that the Bible speaks about.
If the aliens came and put us in bondage,
so I got
it will fit that too.
Listen, hear me out.
Here's
my one question
see,
to
that's
you.
The problem with
question
the, that's
you.
The problem. You
see,
understand? If the aliens came and
how,
put us
how
in
this
there,
book is, man.
That book would say that the aliens
brother,
were going
to
come.
Here's my question to you.
That's not scientific. That's not scientific.
Here's my question to you. Let's deal with logic and reason. Who calls himself a Jew? The white man, correct?
Correct.
So show me where this prophecy fits the white man that calls himself a Jew.
Where he I'm was not going
to
argue that.
To me. Where he was on cargo slave ships and then he was sold. Where's that fit him? Does it fit him? Yes or no?
No. It does fit him.
This is a goddamn coon.
Coon!
Listen,
and if you go into the old
said.
Law,
now he jumped from this time to the ancient world.
And you jumped because you put me.
But I said
you
this.
Jumped.
I
you
said
jumped.
This.
You don't even know what you're saying. You jumped from here to
in captivity that calls himself a Jew, and he wasn't. Now here it is. You got a black man that said it could fit him. So you know he don't know what he's talking about.
Because I know you're number three now.
Hold on, brother.
You're number three. I have one, two, three. I'm doing five pieces to you.
All right. Let me ask you this one question.
Yes, sir.
And it's a very important question.
Yes, sir.
Is the white man the devil? The white man is the white man.
Is the white man the devil? Yes or no?
I don't want
to. I would like to know.
I don't.
Do we have the same? Hold on, brother. You're not dealing with religion.
The devil is the devil.
We're not dealing with religion, my brother. We're not disagreeing from you. We're not dealing with religion.
He has done devilish acts. Yes.
So therefore,
but he's not the living. We are evil too.
Hold on.
He is evil.
But look, here's the white man. Is he not?
He is not the only
one. Is he the epitome of evil?
Is he? Is not the white man the access of evil?
Evil becomes a part
is
of
he the
man.
Access no. of evil?
No, because the other man
who destroyed
him.
The ozone layer. When the engine, when the steam engine
is that the epitome of the ozone layer is still
brother,
here. It ain't completely
brother,
destroyed.
Brother,
that's not. Now
when,
you got
when
me.
The black man, when the black man
the Arab
the engine,
is just
on, brother,
as devastating
brother,
as this. But see, European
hold on. We're talking about who our people know, which is the white man.
And they
our
know the
people,
Arab.
Hold on, brother.
No, they know
hold
the
on,
Arab,
brother.
Too.
Hold on, brother.
That do people, they or do they
on,
not
brother,
know the Arab?
Hold on, brother.
Do they or
hold
do they
on,
not
brother,
know the
brother?
You don't want
we talking about
you
the white man.
Listen. You're not going
to
be.
Brother, listen,
you need to get a better teacher.
If you
you're
feel
not
that way, go down the block.
You're not going to be.
If you feel that way, go down the block.
Because you're not saying that. If you try to run something about the being
the
devil,
the reason why
you're scientific.
Okay, let's do the next. Okay, let's do the next. Is the Arab the second part of the epitome of evil?
Yes, they are.
Okay, so who is the first part of the epitome of evil?
Man, when he refused to understand the nature of God.
Hold on.
Man,
but hold
man
on. Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Evil.
But the Arab is also a man too. So the Arab said he's
wait,
the second
what?
Part.
What?
Arab is also a man too.
Okay, so now, yeah. Anybody who breaks the law, man. Yes.
I said, what I said was, is the Arabs the second epitome of evil? You said yes. So I'm asking, is the so-called white man the first epitome of evil? That's what I'm asking.
Yes. If you want to do that,
yes or
I
no?
Would say
just like when you
it
asked
me
a second or no. Yes or no? Just
yes,
like when,
yes
you
or no
when I asked you about
the
Arabs. Yes or no?
The Africans who
yes
left
or no.
Africa.
We
who
never,
landed
we went
in the world
Africa.
Ice
we talking about the Arabs.
Right?
All right. We're talking about the Arabs, we went beyond Africa. We're talking about the Arabs. Right. I asked you, is the Arabs the second
there was,
the
there is no
said,
white
yes.
man.
I said the
there is no white man.
Man.
That was the so-called white man.
The Caucasian man.
So,
the
mix, the mix,
the
mix.
The
one who came from
the
Caucasus Mountains.
The
ones who came from the Caucasus Mountains. Thank
okay,
you very much.
People.
Yes,
those
yes, they were evil. Yes, they were evil. Yes,
okay.
Yes.
And that's
they
the same very,
became,
and that's the same very crackers you see walking around today. Yes or
that's
no?
That's right.
Yes or no?